Water's always been scarce in Arizona, but one thing that we have to be proud of is consistently Arizonans have been able to make better and better use of their crops and their water. Hi, my name is Ethan Orr. I'm the Associate Director for Agriculture and Natural Resources and Economic Development for the Arizona Cooperative Extension. We use less water now as a state than we did in 1962, even though we have over three times the population and the value of our crop production is almost twice as much.
Water has always been an issue in Arizona. We live in a desert, we know that. What's new in these last few years is the drought that is exacerbating those water, the water constraints that we have are reflecting themselves in Colorado River shortages being implemented and those impacts distributed throughout the state for farmers as well as our cities. And so we're going to have to respond to that.
You know, I've been in Arizona a couple decades. My entire work time in Arizona has been delivering water to farmland. I've seen a lot of changes in the last two decades in the way farmers are able to use water. At their own dime in the past, I've seen farmers go from flat flood irrigating to laser leveled flood irrigating to GPS leveled flood irrigating to using sprinkler irrigation in combination with flood irrigation, furrow irrigation, drip irrigation on certain crops. There's still more efficiencies to be gained, and those are very expensive.
Representative Dunn had the idea that he would like to create a knowledge base of science-based information to draw from. Individuals who we worked with in the development of the grant include other legislators, vendors, farmers, but most importantly, is the University of Arizona Cooperative Extension. We worked very closely with them in the development of this grant.
Last year in the discussions at the Capitol, there was $30 million I asked for to be a statewide program to the Cooperative Extension to convert from flood to drip, try to get efficiencies so that we can take growers throughout the state to try to bring them to the level that we're doing here in Yuma. The grant's designed to go across the state, Cochise County, Mojave County, Pinal County, Maricopa County, trying to be able to utilize what adapts to their area of the best. Sign up for 3 years, it's $1,500 per acre, you know, and you meet the benchmarks, and then the benefit is that you are able, if we have on some coming cuts, that you're already ready for those cuts. We can continue to grow the crops we're growing without, you know, being able to be ready for a 6/10 of a cut or 1 acre foot cut. And so not only in the produce, but also utilizing some of these drip systems in the secondary crop, whether it's a cotton or alfalfa or some other things like that. So it's for all crops.
Hello, my name is Eddie Good. I'm an agribusiness manager for an irrigation company on the West Coast. Today we're here in the Gila Valley of Yuma, Arizona, standing next to a field of sprinklers that can provide almost 20% irrigation efficiency improvement over flood irrigation. Those numbers can go even higher when coupled with automation and or sandy soils.
Everybody eats and they're involved in agriculture. The hard part is getting that message across to generations removed from the farm. First off, the Agribusiness Water Council of Arizona, we were established back in 1978 to respond to proposed water legislation, which was the Groundwater Management Act. And the goal of our organization and our members, which are predominantly irrigation districts, is to stretch our water supplies, increase our yields using less water, always looking for opportunities to innovate. There's a lot of advancements. Some areas I don't know how much more efficient you can be. Every farmer, they'll look at everything that's out there. If they can improve, increase their yields, their profit, using less water, they'll do it. I think there's a reason why farmers do what they do instead of relying on outside farmer interests coming and trying to dictate what they do. They know what to do. They've done it for years.
Hello, my name is Ernesto Amador with Yuma Organic. We are an organic herb grower here in the Yuma Mesa area in the state of Arizona. We were one of the first to implement an irrigation system with drip, and due to the financial hardships of the pandemic, we've been struggling for the upkeep. But this particular grant has allowed us, or will allow us, to to continue to conserve as much water as possible and to produce the best tasting veggies and herbs imaginable.
We took the first $30 million and invested $23 million of it directly into on-farm irrigation systems. The private sector farmers matched that with $17 million of their own. So 42% of our project cost was matched or came from the private sector. In those projects, we conserved over 36,400 water acre feet annually. To put that in context, that's 12 times the size of Tempe Town Lake conserved every year by investing in agriculture. This year, the legislature has allocated another $15.2 million to our program, and we're excited to build more partnerships to save more water.
So this is a great example of people coming together to solve a crisis. I particularly want to thank Representative Tim Dunn and Jordy from state government for drafting and sponsoring this legislation in order for government to be involved with university folks, particularly Dr. Ethan Orr from the Extension Service, also the county agents and technical people with U of A Extension that's involved, also the businesses, ABWC, Agribusiness and Water Council with Chris Udall and Stephanie Knight. This is a great example of everyone coming together to solve this problem, and I'm particularly thankful for the citizens of Arizona to get this program in effect. Thank you.